Hello everyone and welcome to Serendipity in Quarantine. Today we are going to see 11th Standard Political Science NCERT, that is Indian Constitution at Work, and we'll be seeing the first chapter from it, that is Constitution, Why and How. So in this chapter basically we will be learning why the Constitution was necessary, how it was formed and how it makes it is made a legitimate source of rules. So let's go ahead. So why do we need a constitution? We know that India is a very diverse country having different types of group. For example, different religious groups, different castes, different group who has various levels of sources of income, people of different age, of different gender, etc. But in the end, we all have to live together in peace. So all this diversity need to coordinate among each other. So what does constitution do? It provides some basic rules which are publicly promulgated and they are known to all members of the society. Also they are enforceable, hence people will respect them. So it is the first function of the constitution, that it provides set of basic rules that allows for minimal coordination among the member of the society. Then what is the second? Second function is it provides specification of decision making powers. So constitution is a body of fundamental principle according to which the state is constituted and governed. For example, India follows parliamentary system of government. So the constitution will specify who has the power of to make decision in the society, and it also decides how the government will be constituted. Then the third function is it provides limitation on the power of the government. For example, if there is a majority and rule, then there are possibilities that the minorities will get discriminated. Hence, the constitution limits the powers. It provides some set of limits on which government can impose on the citizens. These limits are fundamental in the sense that government may never trespass them. The most basic example of this is fundamental rights. So fundamental rights limits the power of the government which cannot violate basic human rights of the citizen. So citizen will be protected from being, for example, from being arrested arbitrarily or for no reason. This is under fundamental right article 22. So some of the basic liberties and freedom of the citizen are protected by this fundamental rights. So but there are also still some reasonable classification. For example, these rights can be limited during the times of national emergency, and the constitution specifies the circumstances under which these rights may be withdrawn. So in the chapter of national emergency we'll be seeing how these rights can be limited. Then the next function is it provides aspiration and goals of the society. So our constitution makers did not only make constitution to limit the powers of the government or to provide a set of framework under which the government will work, but it also provided some aspiration and goals to the society. These are some positive things. For example, the constitutional makers aspire that India will become free of caste discrimination. So for that they made various provisions to uplift those who face the caste discrimination. So it also included people having different visions and ideology. For example, this cartoon shows that a former Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru is trying to cooperate between the people from two different ideologies while making the constitution. So the Indian constitutional, in the end, it enables the government to take positive welfare measures for some of the and some of which are legally enforceable. For example, in preamble it is mentioned that equality has to be maintained among the different groups of the society. Then there are also fundamental rights which are enforceable legally. Then directive principles of the state policy, it provides vision in which welfare of the society can be made. So the fourth function is to enable government to fulfill aspiration of a society and create condition for just society. So these were some of the functions of the society. Constitution. Then also constitution provides fundamental identity of the people. So there can be multiple types of identity. For example, a political identity, that means a person can be a voter or being elector, person who wants to get elected, etc. Then it sets authoritative constraints upon what one may or may not do. So it defines what are the fundamental values of one and what one should limit oneself and should not trespass. So it also provides a moral identity. This can be provided through fundamental duties of the constitution. And sometimes it also respects the constitutional tradition and moral values that are shared across different constitutions. So in most of the nations, they are made after the amalgamation of complex set of historical tradition. They have to live together as different groups which reside within the nation in different ways. For example, in this picture we can see that after the collapse of Saddam Hussein's regime in Iraq, there was a new constitution maker. So in Iraq there were different types of ethnic groups, for example Sunni, Shiites, Kurds, etc. So there was multiple conflict between these different ethnic groups which made the base of the constitution very fragile. So the constitution has to be strong enough so that all the groups are represented equally and everyone's rights are respected. So now we will be seeing what is exactly constitution, how effective is the constitution, and is constitution just. So when we ask for a constitution of a country, we usually refer to a document. But in some countries like United Kingdom, for instance, they do not have a single piece of document. They actually have series of documents and decisions that are taken collectively and they are referred as a constitution. But in case of India, we have a set of documents. So constitution can be either document or a set of document. Then how it is promulgated? So sometimes in many countries, the constitution was made or crafted by the military leaders or leaders who were not popular. So they did not have the ability to carry the people with them. So people did not supported these constitution makers. But in case of India or South Africa or United States, the constitution was made aftermath of the popular national movement. So usually the national freedom fighters were the members of the constituent assembly. So people supported them vividly. So in case of India, the constituent assembly was made between December 1946 and November 1949. So and it drew upon long history of nationalist movement that had remarkable identity to take along different sections of the Indian society together. So it has enormous legitimacy. Then it also had immense public credibility at all the terms were negotiated and there was so many debates held on this topic. So the final document reflected broad national consensus at that time. So in many countries there were referendum held while passing the constitution, but in India there was never a referendum because still it had enormous public authority because it had the consensus and the backing of the leaders who were popular. So people supported this leader and these leader passed the constitution, hence it was legitimate. So the authority of the people who enact constitution helps to determine in parts its prospects of success. Then there comes what were the substantive provisions in the constitutions. So In case there can be some of the issues like majorities oppressing minorities, or there can be some constitution who provide privileges to some members of the constitution, or there can be sometimes a situation in which one group can feel that their identity is being stolen. So in such cases constitution usually fails. So the more constitution preserves freedom and equality of all its members, the more likely it will succeed. So how it can be made? So for example, in our country there is balanced institutional design. So the well-crafted institution usually provides power to the society intelligently, so that no single group is subvert in the constitution. So usually what it does, it fragments powers across different constitution. For example, in India there is horizontal fragmentation between institutions like legislature, executive, judiciary, etc. There are also independent statutory bodies like election commission. There are sometimes vertical fragmentation of power, for example in case of union state and local self governments. So in this way there is balance achieved. So our constitution usually strike right balance between certain values and norms, and also procedures as authoritative, and at the same time it allows flexibility. So our constitution is called the living document, because it strikes the balance between possibility to change the provisions and also at the same time limit on some changes. So the constitution has ensured that it will survive as document respected by people. So as time changes, there are some changes required in the constitution to justify the society. So the constitution's flexibility allows it to change as per the time requires. So how was the Indian constitution made? So we'll see this in the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Please tune in for the next video of this chapter's continuation. If you like this video, please share, subscribe to this channel. Thank you.